Associated Press Broadcasters Association Awards for Excellence.
Promoting and advancing the craft and microbrew culture in Northeast PA.
This is another edition of
The Friday Beer Buzz!
Yes, the Friday Beer Buzz. It happens every Friday, and it is the three-time winner, by the way. Three-time winner of the Pennsylvania Association of Broadcasters Excellence in Broadcasting Award, the recipient of two Pennsylvania Associated Press Broadcasters Associations Awards for Excellence.
I'm breathe, out of breath, Jason, with this. Breathe.
Promoting and advancing the craft and microbrew culture in Northeast Pennsylvania. All right, this is another edition of the Friday Beer Buzz. Lindo is here from 17's. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
How are things with you?
Oh, fantastic.
If anyone is loves or cares about Lindo, he left his cell phone at home. That's a very bearing, it's a scary feeling.
You know, I got out of the truck, walked in, and I'm like, oh, wait, where's my phone?
Yeah. It's the worst feeling. I would feel like I was pantless.
How do we live without them?
Well, we're watching a real case of it right now. How are you doing, okay?
That's why I'm shaking.
You can see. And we have Bill, as usual. Bill is on the phone now from mybeerbuzz.com. Bill, good morning.
Happy Friday. Phoning it in for another week.
Now, when you say it like that, it sounds like you're being lazy, but no, you're not. You are the beer connoisseur. You are doing all this stuff to give us beer news.
So we did.
What?
Hey, no, I was going to say, we did 500 plus shows, and up until a year ago, they were all in person in the studio except for one. And the one I did was a horrific snow day, and that one I actually phoned it in. But yeah, it is both convenient and odd to be on the phone to try to do the show.
That's okay. We're going to make the best of it. And I have a question for you, because we're going to get to beer news here. Dogfish Head Miami. Is Zoop and Zap and Zip are like words, and is that a new beer? I think I have them in the wrong order. This is the first bit of beer. What is going on? Because I saw this on your site, and I do have it backward. It's Zip, Zap, Zoop?
Yeah. So we have followed along with Dogfish Head Miami. And if you're familiar with Dogfish Head Brewing Company, they're based in Milton, Delaware, is their main facility. But after their acquisition by Boston Beer, which everyone is familiar with, Sam Adams, Boston Beer had a brewery called Concrete Beach in Miami, Florida, and they've turned that into what they're calling the Dogfish Head Miami Residency. So Dogfish Head is now brewing out of Florida. It seems to be mostly 16-ounce cans, and they have three new beers coming. One is one you just mentioned, Zip, Zap, Zoop. And actually, there's an exclamation point on that, so it's Zip, Zap, Zoop. And that's a hazy IPA that has water-soluble hop terpenes in it. Now, as soon as you say terpenes, people immediately go to marijuana. And you will find that hops and marijuana have a lot in common. They are part of the same plant family. But terpenes are simply aromatic compounds. And in this case, they come from hops. So there's nothing with Zip, Zap, Zoop, there's nothing to do with marijuana or anything like that. But that one's 6.3% ABV, and it is coming in 16-ounce cans. They have another one that has an odd name, and if you follow along with some of the breaking news we've done over the last few months, Dogfish Head Miami likes to use unusual Florida-grown fruit. This beer is called Must Be the Mamey, and that is M-A-M-E-Y, and it uses a fruit called Mamey Sapote fruit, and it's a sour ale that hits 8%. And I've never had Mamey Sapote fruit, and I don't know if anyone else there has had Mamey Sapote fruit. So I looked it up, and they said the flavors of Mamey are somewhere between an apricot and a sweet potato.
So that's really an impossible description. Like, I feel like there's no way we can have any idea what that means. Like, they're just so different. Like, what would be the halfway point? Like a bland, like a sweet potato or a bland apricot?
Yeah. <don't know. laughs>
Not sure.
I think it's sort of a dull flavored apricot would be my guess. Sort of an earthy apricot, let's just say. Yeah. And you know what this means, Jason? Someone is going to have to volunteer to drive to Miami and get one so that we can figure out, you can get the beer or you can just get the fruit.
We could do both. I think we probably could do both. I would eat a Mamey. I think I would. I don't think I've ever said that before, but
can we get the station to pay for plane tickets to go for a Mamey?
I don't know if we can get at this point. I don't know if we get the station to pay for the parking in the parking garage. Like, I don't know. Or, like, what is it, a quarter for every 15? No.
It was just an idea.
I mean, I have lots of these ideas, and it's like, what do you mean you need paper for the printer? Bring your own. It's really just a different environment in 2021.
Bring your own paper or bring your own printer?
And both, yeah. What else do you got with beer news?
Our third beer coming from Dogfish Head Miami Residency is part of the 1913 collection, they're calling it. And it is a rye barrel-aged oatmeal stout that will hit 9.5% ABV. And they tell me that this is sort of a cocktail-inspired series of beers. And it is inspired by the Miami-Dade Prohibition cocktails, or pre-Prohibition and post-Prohibition cocktails. And this one sounds like an old-fashioned or something along that line, but we'll watch for that one as well. That is also 16-ounce cans. Coming to us, our next piece of news, coming to us from Kalamazoo in Comstock, Michigan, Bell's is coming up with a beer called Wild Spruce Chase. And that is an IPA, which, you know, Lindo and I are big IPA fans. But this is an IPA brewed with spruce tips. And so they go out to the spruce trees, and they collect spruce tips. And that sort of takes care of the bitter, hoppy portion of the beer. So instead of hops, this beer uses spruce tips. The beer will hit 6.5% ABV. And coincidentally, today, this very day, the 9th of July, is actually the 38th birthday of Bell's Brewery. And if you call it Bell's Brewing, the founder will get very, very upset with you. So 38 years at Bell's Brewery.
Is it a fun upset where he like plays along, or does he get angry and throw you out?
No, angry and throw you out kind of thing. It's a family name. His name is Larry Bell. We've had him on the show.
Okay.
Good guy and everything. But he is very particular that you call it Bell's Brewery, because it is B-E-L-L apostrophe S.
Gotcha. Okay.
Possessive.
I will keep that in mind if I ever end up there. All right, what else is next?
You ever end up in Comstock. And our last piece comes to us from the brewery in Placentia, California, and Boulevard in Kansas City, Missouri. They are teaming up for a beer called One and Done, and that is D-U-N-N. So there's probably a reference there that I'm not aware of. But One and Done will be a double rye whiskey barrel imperial stout. So wrap your head all around that. It's a rye whiskey barrel aged imperial stout, which I've had many of. Very good beer, very good combination of things. And I will tell you, just as a teaser standpoint, if you happen to love coffee and you happen to love beer, that in the next hour on mybeerbuzz.com, there will be some exciting beer news breaking there in less than an hour.
Oh, my goodness gracious. This is the Friday Beer Buzz, powered by Sabatini's Pizza, Sabatini's Bottle Shop and Bar in Exeter. I was supposed to say this up front, and my apologies. My computer's freezing. It's been one of those days, Lindo. Sabatini's with the area's greatest selection of rare craft and imported beers, growlers, and crowlers, and 37 rotating draft Sabatini's Pizza, Sabatini's Bottle Shop and Bar, Wyoming Avenue in Exeter. But Lindo Sabatini's here. You brought in a beer today, and I asked the same question I asked last time when you said it was a, what's it again? What beer is this?
Well, our beer today comes to us from Newburgh Brewing and Bonn Place Brewing Company. It is a collaborative beer, and I'm sorry for interrupting, Lindo. It is called Salted Nut Roll Cream Ale, and I'll let you take it from there.
Well, this beer is inspired by a candy. So I guess Pearson's, which I'm not familiar with, but Pearson's makes a salted nut roll candy.
Is that the one? I think it's cream in the middle. Is that?
And it does.
I have seen this before.
And this is what they were going for, inspired by my friend at Bonn. Sam is fantastic. He's a little out there when it comes to different ideas with beer, and everything he's brewed that I've tried, I love. So the fact that this was his concept, and Newburgh Brewery, they've done a lot together. They've had a couple other IPA collaborations, but this one is a little, I picked it because it was a little different. I mean, there's not a lot of peanut roll beers out there.
Well, yeah, it's, I can only think of seven. No, there's none. I have no idea if there's any, really.
Bill, have you ever heard of anybody trying to come out with a nut roll beer before?
Yeah, so ironically, the nut roll is Pearson's Nut Roll. And it's very much like a Payday bar. So it's sort of a niche candy bar. It's not exactly like Payday. But actually, in 2020, last year, a brewery called Tin Whiskers collaborated with Pearson's Candy, and they also did salted nut roll. But this one has more local roots for us. Newburgh Brewing in Newburgh, New York, started in 2012 by Chris Basso. And Barn Place Brewing in Bethlehem, PA, started in 2016 by Sam and Gina Masoto. They have a very small, Barn Place is a seven-barrel system. And if you're familiar with that term, a barrel is about 31 gallons. So every time they do a batch, they do about 31 times 7 gallons of beer. And this one, I think, is really unique. It is 7.5% ABV. It is 10 IBU. So if you know IBU is the representation of bitterness in a beer, it's international bitterness units or international bittering units, 10 is low. So 10 implies sweet. But this is a cream ale, so I got to ask, are you tasting sweet and salty and any of that stuff, or are you tasting sort of a creamy, soft mouthfeel, slightly dry and refreshing?
I'm going to pass this one to Brian. I want to hear what he has to say. Brian,
I'm going with the latter on that one. Is that it?
Okay.
Yeah, there's definitely taste the saltiness of the peanut in it, but...
Yeah, so it's confusing... Because cream ale is a term that was made up in the 1800s. And this is actually an imperial cream ale, which just means it's a little bit stronger. But there's no cream involved. This beer has peanut flour, vanilla, lactose, which is milk sugar, and salt. And lactose imparts a sweetness without amping up the alcohol, without fermenting out into alcohol. But a cream ale was really just a marketing ploy. And it was a lighter lager that they made in the 1800s. And they made it with corn. And one of the distinguishing features of a cream ale is that it ferments faster. So that back in the 1800s, it gave you an advantage over your competition in that you could produce beer faster. But there's no cream involved in this. There's no cream in it. This particular one has lactose in it, but that's not a traditional cream ale. And it is a pure marketing technique that was meant to mimic the reference to a cream soda. And it just meant that it was, like, rich and fulfilling and satisfying and refreshing.
Interesting. It is definitely
so
one of those...
Is it all of those things?
I don't know. Again, it's interesting. I love... Maybe it's just my basic, level. When you up me to level 2 last week?
Yeah, you got up.
But I still feel like such a novice at this. I'm like, I don't know that I appreciate this beer yet and the complexities of it.
Well, Bill, you stole my word because I was going to say...
Yeah.
I was going to say confusing because for me, when I tasted this, I got the salt and I automatically thought that it was going to be sour because I was thinking it was going to be a goza because normally the salty... Yeah. It has that... flavor of the salt brings me to a goza immediately, and then it's not. Then you get the nuts, and it's like, all right, this is different. And I do get it. They did hit it. It is almost like a payday.
And yeah, it is. And people will be familiar with payday and not so much with Pearson's nut roll, salted nut roll. If you look it up, though, it you know, I don't know regionally if it's like a New Jersey thing or if it's a Midwest thing. But I have heard of it. I've never had it. But I have had a payday. And if you've had a payday, I think you will find that this beer is sort of right up that, the dessert stout, the sweet stout, only it's a cream ale.
Love it or hate it, it really doesn't matter. You mentioned the guy is a little out there with his ideas. Mm-hmm. I feel like you have to be that in the craft beer world. You can't just be a guy goes, I'm just going to make a lager. You can't. Or you have to find a way to really get those ideas not onto paper but into reality. You have to think outside the box, and if you can come up with an idea in the checking out at the grocery store, that's a great thing. Well, hey, there's a candy bar. I'll do that.
Just like the beer that Bill was talking about from Miami using the Maymay fruit. I mean, you're trying to make a sour, an imperial sour that hasn't been done, I don't think, but maybe it has, but now that they're doing it.
And this one's called what again, Linda?
This is Pearson's Salted Nut Roll Ale from Newburgh and Bonn Place.
This is when you do not have this one on tap.
This is not on draft. This is in the can, 16-ounce can.
Nice. What else is going on at Sabatini's? Business as usual? Business is booming again? We're back?
Last night was fun. Last night we got hit pretty good. We had a lot of people come in, a lot of good beers on draft, and just having a good time again.
Awesome. Again, Sabatini's Pizza, Sabatini's Bottle Shop Bar and Bar in Exeter. 37 rotating drafts. I got to get down there. I got to come and visit at some point.
You don't have to try all 37, but we'll start you a couple.
We'll get you a ride home, Jason. Don't worry.
Bill, we'll talk to you next week, okay?
Yeah, have a great weekend, everybody.
All right, but it is the Friday Beer Buzz. Again, we do this every Friday. And, yeah, you can check out Lindo and Sabatini's in Exeter. And, yeah, there's a reason. This is the three-time winner. I got all these little notes here, and I'm messing it all up. But, look, we're going to be back and do this again next week. It's another edition of the Friday Beer Buzz, bringing good beers and good people together.